your side, man. Drawing me in and you kicking me out. Got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose and win. Cause I give you of me, and you give me all of you. Oh, how many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around you every moment. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves.
Professional of our beautiful bride, and accompanying her in song is Grammy Award nominated recording artist Carl Carlton.
Yeah, oh yeah, She's beautiful, she's tight, baby. She got all the curves that a man, that a man, that a man, that a man would love. Hey, every time I look at your cold body, baby, you got all the curves a man would love. Got me body on you, baby. Got me body on you, baby, baby, baby. Yeah. My. Baby, I know you bad. Woo-wee. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah.
Congratulations, you are a beautiful mama jam. Poetry in motion. She for the eye to see.
Who gives this woman a holy matrimony? Let us bow our heads and pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to watch the miracle of your love and the power of your spirit. Work in the lives of these two people. Lord, we give you praise, the honor, and the glory for the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives to bring us into a place of union with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and union with one another. We thank you for it in Jesus' mighty name. Everyone say amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Before we begin the actual vows, there's an affirmation that I wrote as I was led by the Holy Spirit. And I want the two of you to listen to these words very carefully and attentively. And this is the confession that you're actually making to each other. And if I read it, then I want you to look at each other and say, I do. Amen. I do make this statement of confession. I believe that God has given me to you to be one as husband and wife. I covet with you to love, honor, respect, and cherish you all the days of our lives. As we become one, joined together by the Holy Spirit in the presence of God and before the heavenly host, I pledge myself to you and to you only. My body will no longer be my own, but we shall walk in the unity of faith, always admonishing each other to be all that we can be, first to God and then to each other. I have already severed ties within a relationship prior to ours, and I commit my love faithfully to you always. I will not stray, and I shall cleave only to you. Even in the most difficult times, I will remember that you are my gift from God. I will call upon him to strengthen me and to give me divine wisdom to overcome and the knowledge to cope with all situations. Lord, help us together to understand that we have an advocate with the Father, and we can go boldly before the throne of grace and receive help in the time of need. I thank you, Father, that our marriage will be a testimony of you, and our union will exemplify the love that Jesus Christ has for the church. Are you in agreement with this affirmation? Amen. Shall we proceed? As I read the scriptures from Ephesians 5, I want you both to pay very close attention to the words stated here. These are God's words that the Holy Spirit will honor as you stand on these words in and by faith. The world has the idea that marriage is simply a legal contract, and it is a legal contract. But at the same time, which is the most important and the most binding, it is a spiritual contract. When words of faith are spoken according to the word of God, between two born-again believers, the power of God goes into operation. A miracle takes place when the faith of these two people is released in God's power. God honors their faith and brings the two of them into union. With these thoughts in mind, listen very carefully to these words as penned in the Holy Scriptures. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. Amen. But the husband is the head, which means that he is not the boss, he is not the ruler, but he is to receive instruction from God and love his wife as Christ loved the church. That makes you the head. Even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject to in Christ, so let the wives be subject to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love his own wife as he loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord the church, for we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and his church. To the groom, Paul, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior? To the bride, Kalyn, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior? Upon this public profession of your faith, you have made known to all men that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is your Lord and he is your Savior. A miracle took place when you made Jesus the Lord of your life. The Holy Spirit is the very power of God, his created power, to cause your spirit to be reborn. It is the same power of God that he raised Jesus from the dead, and he joined you to Jesus by that same power. When two born-again believers come together before God to be joined together as husband and wife, the Apostle Paul calls it a mystery and says, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. When you made Jesus the Lord of your lives, you were joined to him. 1 Corinthians 6 and 17 says, you are one spirit with him. Ephesians 5 and 30 says, you have become one flesh with the Lord. You are his. He is yours. You are one together with him. I want you to understand that if you rightfully discern the body of Christ, then you rightfully discern the miracle that takes place in marriage. Your spirits will be joined together, and you will become one. You will not be one in the eyes of the law only. There's something much more powerful that happens. The very creative power of God will join you together. The same power that joined you with Jesus when you made him your Lord. Don't tamper with that union. The love of God doesn't say, I love you, but do you really love me? The love of God simply says, I love you. Don't ever let the sun go down on your wrath. Something holy, something beyond reproach will take place by the Spirit of God in your side of your bosom, and it is a precious thing. To the congregation, those of you that are witnesses to this powerful ceremony that is taking place here, I read this to you, and I wish that you would listen to it attentively. In the eyes of Almighty God, these two people are washed in the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. They have prayed, and before the Lord God himself, they believe with all their hearts that it is the perfect will of God for them to be joined together in the Spirit. They have made that decision, so from now on until the end of this age, I charge you to do everything in your power to see that this union remains solid, strong, and prosperous. Woe be unto any person who would tamper with this union. Woe be unto any person that will interfere with this union and cause it to be anything other than prosperous in the eyes of God. This is a miraculous thing, and it is of God. To the groom, Paul, do you take Kalyn as your wife? as your own flesh, to love her even as Christ loves the church, to protect her and care for her for the rest of your life. And look at her and say, amen. Repeat after me, I, Paul, look into Kalyn's eyes. According to the word of God, leave my father and mother, and I join myself to you to be a husband to you from this moment forward. We shall be one. Kalyn, this is to you. Kalyn, do you take Paul as your husband, submitting yourself to him as unto the Lord, showing reverence to him as the head of this union for the rest of your life? Look at him and respond.
I do.
Repeat after me. I, Kalyn,
I, Kalyn,
according to the word of God,
submit myself to you
to be a wife to you. From this moment forward, we shall be one. Amen. May I have the ring, please, for this beautiful bride. Oh, nice. A ring is a very precious thing, a token of your faith and your love. He loves you. This ring is made from precious metal. It is an ever-ending circle that indicates the continuing love of God, a love that never fails, never presents itself halted, nor is it puffed up. The love of God and the faith of God causes this power to move in your lives. Wear these rings as a continual reminder of your faith, a continual reminder of the confession of faith you have made to each other and to God. Now, I want you to take this ring. I'll take it, okay? After me, place that on her ring finger. With
this ring,
I be wed. It is a token of my love for you, a token of my faith that I release now in Jesus' name. Amen. May place that ring on her finger. Glory to God. May I have the groom's ring, please? A ring can mean two different things. It can be a never-ending sign of love, or it can be a shackle. I charge you to remember this always. This woman stands by your side, not under your feet, not behind your back, but beside you. You have the responsibility of being the head of this union. You have spiritual responsibilities. I want you to wear this ring in remembrance that she is your helpmate. This ring must never be a shackle of dominance, but always a reminder of faith and love. Take this ring, Kalyn, and place it on this ring finger. And repeat after me, please, looking into his eyes. With this ring, I be wed. I give it to you as a token of my faith.
I believe with all my heart
that this is forever.
That this is forever.
It represents my love. And my faith.
And my faith.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Join right hand, please. As a representative of the Lord Jesus Christ, and an official clergy of the state of Michigan and international, I present you husband and wife. Woo!
Yeah.
him, Paul. I already told you that in this union you have spiritual responsibilities. And as the priest, the prophet, and the king in your home, you are to cover her. You will have the authority and the responsibility to serve communion in your home when you sense trouble approaching, the sickness and disease ever attempts to attack her body. You will take authority over that, and you can serve her holy communion. The Word of God says that by Jesus' stripes we were and we are healed. And this bread represents the broken body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And the same power that was released to us and through Jesus Christ, that same power is being released to you today in the name of Jesus. Many times you have received Holy Communion, but today you're receiving it first. The first sacrament that you're to receive as husband and wife is Holy Communion. And I want you to take this bread. After that, I bless the Father in the name of Jesus. We thank you that this bread is your broken body. And we thank you in the name of Jesus that we are healed right now. We thank you, Father, as we partake of this broken bread, which is your body. We receive all of the miracle work and power in the body and through the body of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Serve your wife first. Place it in her mouth.
And the cup, likewise, is also the shed blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. And the shedding of blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is the sealing of the New Testament covenant, which you both are partakers of. And I want you to serve your wife the cup, which is koinonia, which means the fellowship. Drink it all, can't be bitter. Okay. Now comes the lesson. All issues.
I thank you that you joined them by your Spirit, Father, and they are one. And Father, I pronounce the blessing over them in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I say, blessed art thou in the city. Blessed art thou in the field. May you prosper in all that your hands touch to do to bring glory and honor to the Father. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ that no sickness and disease shall come upon your body. I decree in the name of Jesus that you are fastened together and that you shall cleave together as one for the remaining days of your life in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I speak blessing upon your family. I speak blessings upon your body. If there be any children born of this union, I say that they are blessed and they are favored of the Most High God. Blessed is the peace of our children, and they shall be taught of the Lord. Father, I consecrate them now in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. Walk in love, walk in peace, and walk in faith in Jesus' name. And you may rise.
Now you may legally. to kiss this one. You are husband and wife, please turn and face these great cloud of witnesses. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Lori Clark, Paul and Kalyn Boyd. Say amen.
Shining white like a diamond.